Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Estilos with the Spiel on Entertainment, and I'm here at the Motion Picture Academy Museum in Los Angeles, California, for the LA premiere of the new film, Glass Onion. Now, this film is the highly anticipated sequel to the 2019 smash hit, Knives Out, and it stars Edward Norton, Daniel Craig, and Kate Hudson. And if this film is anything like its predecessor, Glass Onion is destined to be a box office hit.
Across the island, I've hidden clues. You will have to closely observe each other. If anyone can name the killer, that person wins our game. Any questions?
Halle Berry, that has a kick.
Oh my God, what happened? Holy sh!
Ryan, what a great ensemble in this film. What was it like for you putting this cast together, and what were you expecting from them all?
Every movie, it's the same thing. I kind of just write the script and then sit down with my casting director, Mary Verneuil, and we figure out, okay, who can work in these parts? And I feel like I got so lucky with this. I must feel like lightning struck twice, because not just the caliber of actors, but similar to with the first movie, everyone was a genuinely good person, and they all clicked and got along and supported each other as an ensemble. And that's kind of like a little mini miracle. It's pretty amazing.
Now, the nexus of this film being Daniel Craig is the central character. Certainly, he made an incredible impression in the first film. So when you were working out this film with Daniel approaching this second sequel here, what was it that you wanted him to bring to his character that was a little different than the last time?
Well, in terms of the story of this one, it's a little different, because in the first movie, we're kind of coming into the story through Ana de Armas's character, Marta, through her eyes, and Blanc was a little more on the periphery of it. Whereas in this one, we start with Blanc, and we come into this mystery through his eyes, and we're absorbing a lot of the first part of the story through with him. So by its necessity, we're a little bit more seeing it through his eyes, which I thought was really interesting. It was a fun thing to kind of figure out with Daniel, see a little bit more of this guy.
I must insist that nobody touch the body.
Jeez, detective, who killed the party?
I need to find a motive for murder.
Everyone would stab a friend in the back to hold on.
Deal with it.
And Janelle Monáe, I mean, we are talking about a spectacular performance there, a multifaceted performance. When you were approaching her and talking over this role, you know, how did you present it to her and encourage her to take on what is a pretty significant undertaking?
It's a beast of a part. It asks everything you can possibly ask of an actor. She has to be funny, she has to do physical comedy, she has to do action, physical stuff, she has to, you name it, she has to go to deep emotional places and really wrench her heart out. It asked everything of her I could have, and she just more than rose to the occasion. She soared past it, and I watch her performance and what she pulled off. I feel so lucky to have her in the movie. I feel still just in awe of her as an artist, man.
Kate Hudson was telling us earlier about her experience, her significant experience as a dancer, and she wanted you to sort of keep that in mind in terms of the both of you working out the interpretation of Birdie, which is an amazing character, by the way.
Well, Kate has, I mean, the physicality of it, she locked into really quickly. And there's a lot in Birdie in the way that she just moves through a space where you can see the performative kind of element of it. And Kate clicked into that. Kate's also, I mean, she's just such a smart comedic actor. And it takes a really intelligent, really tuned in actor to take a part that's this broad and have it feel defined and real and genuinely funny. So yeah, Kate's amazing.
Look at that.
Now there's two characters that at least were unexpected in terms of the cast. We have the Jared Leto drink and the Jeremy Renner hot sauce. So how were they cast to be such a significant part in this film?
Well, I'm a big fan of both of those guys, but thankfully both of them have a sense of humor. I would totally buy, you know, Jeremy Renner hot sauce. Are you kidding? I think he should put it on the shelves. I think that'd be a good move.
I think we have some merchandising working out for this one.
Let's do it. Come on.
All right. Again, it's an amazing film. I want to thank you for putting together such a great project.
Yeah,
and looking forward to seeing more.
Think of the danger here.
Are you calling me dangerous?
Well, we'll see.
Let it all out.
Hell yeah!
This is reckless. The killer wouldn't hesitate to kill again if it covers their tracks.
Must be really great at Clue, huh?
I'm very bad at dumb things. Ticking boxes, running around, searching all the rooms. It's just a terrible, terrible game.